The World Economic Forum in Davos every year has met the beginning of this year. And the title of their meeting was Creating a Shared Future in a Fractured World. All leaders of the countries that came from all over the world to the Davos meeting came with the same goal that we have here, that we have been having in the Academy since some years ago. I came to Dubrovnik first time 40 years ago to discuss university reform. This was held in those days. There were still different governors around here, different thinking. And the rector of the University of Sarajevo was my host, and he was discussing in a session. There were only two foreigners, myself, rector of Federal University of San Carlos in Brazil, and the rector of the University of Mexico, the largest university in Latin America, 300,000 students. So we came here and we were discussing succession in universities. Their discussion, they were having three or four candidates. They selected one lady, biochemist, she was fantastic. But then the rector of Sarajevo turned to me and said, she's excellent, but she is not going to be selected. I said, why? She's not a member of the party at that time. Okay? In Brazil, that time, to choose a rector, we had to have five names submitted to the Minister of Education, submitted to the President. So we were discussing what is the best way to select a leader on education. So education was the main concern at that time. And education is also an important topic for the World Academy. We are having almost every year a special event in different countries. We just had it in Brazil this year, and next year will be in Serbia, and the following year in Georgia, and so we hope to have different views of this issue around the world. So I love the Academy for all that has been doing all the years, but the founding fathers of the Academy, 60 years ago, they said that they wanted a global world university. World university. In those days, they tried. As a matter of fact, I read the proceedings, the history. They created a university council, they met, but they gave up, because where to sit the global university with foreign professors and foreign students? There was a big dispute, we didn't move forward. But in these days of new communications, internet, etc., I think we are going to move in that direction. So the World Academy decided in 2013 to organize a meeting at the University of California, Berkeley, where we decided really to create a new institution, which we finally approved it in the Library of Alexandria because of connection with the past. So we had the recreation of this World University Consortium, which we hope will develop also in the next few years, especially I see here so many young people. We need many young people, good ideas to think of the future of education. We had a good meeting in Rio de Janeiro. Marcel, who is a young man here, was there, gave good ideas, raised different points. But he was asking me yesterday, what are the governments going to do with the recommendations of your conference? We may have a good conference, but what's going to happen afterwards? Is that your question, Marcel? Okay, so I just explained to him that we are going to have, probably in another week, you can all see it, all we discuss in Rio will be online. Virtual Educa in Madrid is going to put it online, and World Academy is also going to have it online. So you can see what we discussed in Rio during three wonderful days with many university participants from different parts of Latin America, and I hope we can move forward here. But I wanted to say another thing which I did not mention. Education is an important issue, but it's not the only one. The World Academy has met this last few days to discuss the future plans, strategic plan for the Academy for the next 10 years. So there are other issues which are coming on, and I think the young people here should be aware of those issues. How can you contribute ideas? We need new ideas. We need new members of the World Academy. Maybe this will be future members here among the students that are present today. So I hope that you can also think of the UN Sustainable Development Goals. This is agenda for 2030. Not too far away, only 12 years away. And I remember I was talking here, was 40 years ago, the same issues that we discussed at that time still are around. We could not really move very much forward. Although we are improving, I hope that we will move forward in the next few years. And I wish all of you, the newcomers here, to try to understand more what we have been doing on the last 40 years. Well, actually, 6 years in 2020.
Six, right?
So it's a good time. We need good ideas. See, come up with suggestions after you participate in this important topics of the global governance. I just wanted to finish by mentioning two things. A few days ago, I was looking in some statistics about global military expenditures. We have been spending in the world today more than $1,000 billion. Unless we discuss this, there's not much chance for global governance. Okay. Second thing, the International Monetary Fund is saying that we're going to eliminate poverty before 2030. Okay, Oxfam sent a report a few months ago. 62 people, 52 of them men, own as much wealth as the poorest half of the entire world population. So, unless we try to change that, so that's part of your global governance challenge that I hope we can all think about that and see how can we go. But you see the topics which are in this schedule of lectures here is excellent. So I'm going to attend all of them because I want to learn more. So how we can find solutions. I don't know if I can contribute much more, but I have children, 5 grandchildren, and I hope I can give them this challenge when I go back home. Thank you very much.
Thank you.